Well, here we are at the Mitchell Nursery in King, North Carolina. It's a beautiful fall day, and we're out here in the plot of Hardy Mums. We're looking at Hardy Mums, and we have with us the founder and proprietor of Mitchell's Nursery, Judy Mitchell, here to share her knowledge about how to care for these beautiful hardy chrysanthemums. Hey, Judy.
Hey, how are you?
We're good. Judy, one question that comes up for us quite often is, what's the difference between a hardy mum and a, I guess you'd call it, a non-hardy mum?
Hardy mums, the garden mums are the hardy mums. Mm-hmm. There are florist mums that are grown primarily for pot plants. Sometimes they will come back, sometimes they won't. But the garden mums are grown to be hardy.
And when we say hardy, are you talking zones here, or what's the lowest zone they'd be hardy in?
I'll be honest with you, I don't know that.
It's all right.
I know they do well around here. As long as you take care of them and plant them right. I always leave them in a pot or wherever you want to sit them while they're pretty. This is ideal stage to buy them at.
Okay.
And I'd like to buy them before they get this stage.
What size pot are they in right now?
These are 8-inch pots.
8-inch pots. 8-inch pots are really good. And what you're saying is you take them and you bring them home, you set them out on the table, you know, whatever, set them on the front porch, on the steps, whatever. Keep them, you water them,
keep
I guess.
Watered.
Okay. And then after that, what happens?
When they start getting past the peak, like this one right here, I go ahead and clean off the dead blooms right here on it.
Uh-huh.
And that keeps them looking good. And then when they get too many, all the dead blooms go, and when they get mostly dead, I go ahead and plant them in the yard,
mm-hmm.
keep them watered till the frost really kills them back down hard.
Okay, and when they die back, do you cut off the top and let it come back again, or you just leave the dead stems laying there till spring?
I usually cut the blooms off, leave the greenery
uh-huh.
after they finish blooming, leave the greenery till the greenery dies back on its own. I usually pull leaves up around them, mulch them good through okay. the winter, and cut them back come springtime when you see the new growth coming out.
Excellent. And do they, we've had mums at home where they come out early. Is that a good thing when they start to bloom early, or do you need to cut those back?
Most times when they bloom early, that means they don't have quite enough fertilizer. They are very heavy feeders. They like a lot of fertilizer.
And what's your recommended ratio in the fertilizer?
If you're using Osmocote, just follow the directions. Just be sure you apply it early spring when they first come out. Apply it again in July. Usually it lasts about 3 months, and then that should take you through the fall season.
Excellent. Well, when these things are in the ground, how long do they actually live? Do they sort of propagate themselves and spread, or do they kind of eventually fade?
They will spread for a while. Most times eventually they'll start dying out in the center, and they may just die out. They're not a long-lived perennial, but they are a perennial.
Okay. About how many years would you say
guys? Four or five out of them, you're doing good.
4 to 5 years. Well, they sure are gorgeous, and you have a lot of varieties out here. These red ones in particular, they're sort of like a fall color, aren't they?
They start almost look like gonna be red, and then they more orangey bronze when they open up.
Right, and you've got some white ones back here, and more of the yellow.
And look, dark purple.
Oh, wow, those are just gorgeous.
Yeah, we've got some really red ones back there, too.
All right. Well, Judy, thank you so much for your time and all the information you imparted to us. We really appreciate it. And folks, if you want to subscribe to our channel here, just go up on the YouTube and hit the subscribe button. If you want some alerts, go ahead and hit that alert bell and you'll get some good alerts. I think we pretty well covered on how to care for your hardy chrysanthemums, or mums as they're shortened in a form of calling them. Judy, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And come see Judy. She's out here at the Mitchell Nursery in King, North Carolina. It is a beautiful nursery. We come here all the time, and we just love hanging out. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. It's such a beautiful day.
It is.